Well, there's no question. Jerusalem is an extremely important aspect of the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. And any resolution will have to include a mutually agreed upon formula for the city of Jerusalem, which is extremely important to both sides. But the interesting part here is that how the Democratic Party or President Obama sees it versus how Romney sees it. So politics aside, if you look at the two versions or two references to Jerusalem, the Democratic Party, for example, in the platform says that Jerusalem is and will remain the capital of Israel. The parties have agreed that Jerusalem is a matter of final status negotiation. It should remain an undivided city accessible to people of all faith. So here, the Democrats left an opening, that is, the future of Jerusalem remains subject to negotiation, albeit it is the capital of the state of Israel, but does not have necessarily to be exclusively the capital of Israel, albeit it should remain united, which is the position actually that I take. When you look at the language of the Republican platform on Jerusalem, it says, we support Israel's right to exist as a Jewish state, which is fine also for the Democratic Party for that matter, with secure, defensible borders, and we envision two democratic states, Israel with Jerusalem as its capital and Palestine, living in peace and security. But here, the difference in nuances in the language, it doesn't suggest that the Palestinians should have a capital in Jerusalem as well. And this is where politics really come to play. If the Republican were honest, or I should say if Romney was honest as well on this particular issue, he should know that there will be no peace between Israel and the Palestinians unless Jerusalem become also a capital of the Palestinian future state, because this is not an issue just for the Palestinian. It is an issue for the entire Arab world. No Arab state will support any kind of peace agreement between Israel and the Palestinian unless there's a clear understanding and that Jerusalem be also the seat, the capital, for the new Palestinian state. So for Romney and others to play with this, to appease the Israelis, to appease the Jewish community, or to appease any other evangelicals for that matter, it's simply misleading and it won't work. It's a very touchy issue. You see, no one really wanted to deal with this sensitive issue of Jerusalem. And so there were many Democrats within the party who felt, why just not leave it and make only reference to the United States commitment to Israel national security, which incidentally President Obama expressed that Americans' commitment to Israel national security is unwavering. That's what he stated in his speech Thursday night. Well, the Republicans who are pandering for Israel support or the Jewish support or all the support that they think they can garner as a result of their position on Jerusalem were more than happy to include such a language, knowing actually full well that they will not be able to live up to what the platform is actually saying.